to our beginning, I would like to invite up onto stage several of our very important friends and supporters for the last 20 years. This is Stacy White from U.S. Department of State, who works with culture, and we're so excited that she's here.
Congratulate Dana and his company for all the wonderful work they've been doing for the last 20 years. It may interest you to know that, in fact, your State Department not only conducts business with governments abroad and tries to promote U.S. policies abroad, we also try to showcase the best of American artistic talent and create cultural exchange programs. They really are one of the most important things that the State Department does abroad, because it gives the opportunity for peoples in other countries to really connect with us and understand much better about what American culture is. And standing right here next to me is one of the most wonderful examples of the kinds of people who participate in this program, because Dana has had such a distinguished relationship with the State Department that you'll have to pardon me, I'll have to put my glasses on and read all the places he's been in. It is what it is, right? Well, you know, Dana is an Asian American himself, and he grew up in the Southwest, so in many ways he is an exemplary and typical American. He has wonderful talents, he has a sense of cultural identity that is both American and also very distinct and unique for what it is. So when he travels abroad with his programs and his company, they not only put on this stunning performance that communicates beyond language what we're about as a people, but he also carries his own unique identity with him and allows that kind of personal connection to take place so people can understand who we are. Dana himself has been an avid participant in the Department of State. He's participated in different programs. We have Fulbright exchange programs. He has been on a grant to study traditional dance in Pakistan. He did his Fulbright senior scholarship in Peru. He's been a cultural envoy and a performing artist for our cultural programs, and he works with our U.S. embassies in these communities abroad in several countries, from Mexico to Mongolia, from India to Israel, from Egypt and the West Bank to Ecuador and Korea, from Panama and Peru to Latvia and Russia. Is there a continent that you haven't been to? Can we make that happen for you? Finally, I just want to say that I'm standing here too on behalf of all the people whose lives he's touched abroad and back here in Washington as well. Right now, he has two people with him, two dancers who he brought from Chile and from Mongolia, who are here spending a year on an exchange program right here. So I'd also like to extend a welcome to Felipe and Orbayar and thank them for the special contribution they've made to increasing our understanding of other cultures through their participation in Dana's party here tonight. And I also want to kind of acknowledge the strong international contribution he's brought to George Washington University's Master of Dance program through all the experiences that he's now integrated into his own art form. So on behalf of Assistant Secretary of State Ann Stock and all the people you've touched, and in fact, our Secretary of State Hillary Clinton, who is a deep believer in the smart power of diplomacy, what could be more smart than the kind of connections we have going on here tonight? Thank you.
Good evening. I'm Lionel Thomas, the Executive Director of the D.C. Commission on the Arts and Humanities. I'm very pleased to be here, standing next to a very lovely lady, Julie Koo, from the Office of Asian Pacific Islander. I'd like to congratulate Dana, who we were reminiscing a little while ago how long I've known Dana. I've known Dana for at least 20 years. And I remember when he took this small seed of a dream of a company, and it grew into 20 years later, and congratulations for that. I'd like to also congratulate the patrons, the supporters, and all the people who have been involved with the company, and certainly want to continue success. We're very happy that you're once again being supported by the D.C. Commission on the Arts and Humanities as one of the things that make us great as a city is the diversity of our city, and it is our strength, and I can't say enough about it. I think President Clinton coined it that the diversity was our strength, or is our strength as a nation, and certainly your company is indicative of what kind of creativity can come out of, you know, the cultural experiences that we have. And certainly I believe in the arts, and I wake up every morning with the charge of trying to do something better to make arts and culture thrive in this city, to create an environment where arts can thrive. And that's my charge. And I'm certainly very happy to also be here on behalf of Mayor Vincent Gray, who unfortunately could not be here today, but would want to actually send his congratulatory remarks as well. And I'm going to let the lovely lady also speak. She's just not Vanna White.
Hi, good evening everyone. My name is Julie Koo, and definitely Dana Tyson Burgess and his company has been a very important part of our community, Asian American community, and also the art community in DC, and also the greater Washington DC area and the nation here. The Mayor Gray really wanted to come here today, but unfortunately he has another competing event that he couldn't come, but he just wanted to make sure that he will bring letter of greetings to Dana Tyson Burgess and his company. And I'm not gonna read the whole thing because you guys are here to see his performance, but I just wanted to really make sure that he has really done a great job in the art community and also the entire Asian American community. And he's been a great asset for our community. So I just really wanted to thank you for your support and your great contribution to our community. So I would like to present this, the letter of greeting from the mayor. Thank you so much.